Hi guys, this is Dr. Mahima Bakshi and I'm at the BMW Bird Automotive facility. I have something really exciting for you. I'm your host for Joy Talks, where we'll be driving around with people from different walks of life who have an inspiring story to tell us. And my today's guest is Dr. Rita Jairath. She's an athlete, a bodybuilder, a Bharatnatyam dancer, and lots more. So come, let's find out her inspiring story today. You're an athlete, you're a bodybuilder, you know, you're a Bharatnatyam dancer, you're a writer. I would love to know that, how have you seen yourself transforming in last 10 years in your career?
So I changed from a very young, tender girl to a mother of a special child where I was fighting battles. I had to be very submissive, but then there was a silent warrior in me which wanted to do all that which was not possible, considered possible until now. What happened was that my son, being an autistic child, he wanted to do weight training. I took him with me to the gym. And 20 years ago, it was very unconventional for a woman to do weight training in the first place. And so, you know, I had to really establish myself as being allowed to do things in the midst of all the ridicule that I was facing, especially with a child like that. And, you know, being amongst that, in that domain where there are primarily a lot of men and people stare at you as to what is she trying to do.
So you have been such a strong person, I must say, and you know, you make women proud.
I'm grateful for that. Thank you, you've been very kind.
So Dr. Rita, how have you been able to maintain that balance? Because I feel that somewhere, you know, if I talk about your personal life, you've had your own ups and downs and, you know, you've had your own challenges. Yet at the same time, if you talk about your professional life, you know, even work-wise, you've had your own challenges. So how have you figured out that balance to, you know, strike that balance between your work life and your personal life?
What I do is that I take things one step at a time. Let me do this 100%. And then things fall in place. So this is the principle I apply in everything in life. And so when it comes to multitasking and creating balances, I just do whatever I'm doing, I give my 100%, and we say, you know, we'll see what happens. So that's the key. That thing I apply in different things, and that's how it goes.
Wow, yeah. Amazing. Dr. Rita, you know, you are also a fitness icon, you know, for women in the society. So, you know, a lot of women have been doing online work, especially when we talk about working women in this pandemic times, you know, a lot of work was happening online. So any special fitness tip from your side, being a fitness icon for women?
I would say that, first of all, we need to be kind to ourselves. I hear everybody saying that we are not doing any work as the older generation would do and so on, but we must first tell ourselves that there is so much of stress sitting in front of the computer or at the desktop. You are actually sacrificing your health and life, and that is, you know, tremendous amount of hard work to sit in one place and be focused. It's in fact in a certain way meditative also. Besides that, the physical part, yes, if we are not able to actually go to a gym, we should be conditioning our mind to how to train ourselves. I teach a lot of my clients to, you know, kind of, even if you have this much space, use your body weight resistance. Tell yourself that this is something you need to do it as regularly as eating, sleeping. And yes, and of course, if you can, then you must make the effort in going to the gym. And the diet part, of course, what really means that a human being has to only condition and tell himself or herself that this food is delicious. If you condition your mind on what is good, you will start liking all the good things. So these are the fitness tips I would say. Working women, they must carry their food, their meals with them as much as possible. As much as possible. I know it's not always possible.
So, you know, since March is celebrated as the month of womenhood, you know, 8th of March being International Women's Day. So, I would love to have a message from your side for the women in the society to, you know, inspire them to be stronger, because I think it's very important for every woman to stay strong. Yeah. So what would be that special message from your side?
Well, I would say that life is very precious and we must value the presence of life. And so we won't be here again and again repeatedly. There is no guarantee of that. So we must pursue our passions unapologetically.
It was lovely listening to your story, Dr. Rita. And I must say that, you know, there is a special aura that you carry. And that in itself is quite inspiring for other women.
Thank you so much. Thank you. That's been very generous of you.
So we've been enjoying the chit-chat and, you know, this wonderful drive and the luxury car.
Oh, yes.
How about grabbing a bite and having some nice healthy food now?
Oh yes, that would be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to that.
So let's head for a nice breakfast at the Roseate. Lovely listening to your story, Dr. Rita, and I must say it was really an inspiring one.
Thank you so much.
And I would love to thank you for sparing out time with this lovely BMW hamper for you. Thank you so much.
I absolutely feel so special. Thank you. Yeah. I'm going to cherish this.
So how was the whole experience and the whole drive that you just had, the whole BMW experience?
That was lovely, and as I said, bumps should be left to the metaphorical world.
Mm-hmm.
Life is full of bumps. This was quite a smooth ride, and at least it should not manifest itself in the physicality of it. And definitely, I really enjoyed the entire experience. It was lovely.
Lovely, awesome. And what's the first thing that comes to your mind when you hear the word BMW?
Definitely style, class, and sophistication.
Mm-hmm.
And it is very stylish to travel in a BMW. Every car takes you from one place to another, but then when you go in a BMW, it speaks a lot about yourself, about your life, and how you got there to be in that elite section. It is a lot of hard work too.
I think it's all about creating a story.
Yes, it is.
And I feel that the whole drive, the whole experience, and BMW in itself is a beautiful story.
Absolutely.
And yeah. I'm sure that every woman would correlate her story to it.
Oh, yes, 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 yeah, absolutely.